This is a 1/10 horsepower dishwasher motor, and I've been using a motor like this to make a blower, but with this impeller I actually don't need that much power, so I realized I could get away with making a bigger impeller. Now I need a bigger housing, and I designed that in CAD and I printed out the shapes of the segments, which I'll paste onto here and cut that out on the bandsaw. I glued up pairs of housing pieces together just to make it easier to assemble that housing. And the least curved one actually is the one that goes near the exit. So it's supposed to consume at most 200 watts. And the RPM is too low as well. So I've overloaded my motor. So now with this much airflow restriction, it consumes about the right amount of power. And with this constriction, I now get 14.2 centimeters of head. And static pressure is 17 centimeters. So my housing design has actually got a fairly generous spiral on here to not resist airflow that much, but I've oversized the impeller for this a little bit, so I can't really go full airflow anyways, so it makes sense to try to tighten up this spiral a bit so it's closer to circular, which will cause less power consumption and hopefully slightly more static pressure, but I will lose a little bit of airflow this way. Static suction is now 17.5 centimeters, so up the timing a little bit. And power consumption is 220 watts, so power consumption free flow is down a little bit. So I'm really pushing it with this motor, which is about 0.1 horsepower. I'm actually relying on the filters and hoses and such to restrict the airflow enough so that my motor is not overloaded. Because the less airflow there is going through this blower, the less power it consumes. I got my blower assembled and now I need some kind of filter box, and I've been thinking of just using a cardboard box and mounting a filter to one side and then sucking the air out the top, but I think this cardboard box might not be sturdy enough and it's not quite the right size either. So I went through looking through my scraps of panels and such, and I think I have enough wood that I can use, and my idea now is to actually put two filters in the box and to put those along the top of the box like this, so I have more surface area. Got it all cut up. This is the top, this is going to be the sides, that's the ends, and this is going to be the bottom, which was a little bit too short, so I had to glue a piece on the end. But I sized this box to take advantage of available materials, because this is all the cutoffs from cutting those pieces. I have to drill these holes at a slight angle because the top is barely big enough. I'm cutting off the laminate from the edges of the bottom panel so I can glue it on. After dry fitting the bottom, I took it off again and added glue. The glue is there mostly to seal it up. These filters really aren't meant for that kind of pressure, so I'm adding a support structure for the filter pleats. I need a way to seal and attach the window to the plywood, and duct tape is just the right answer. I screwed that elbow on from the inside, but there was really no room for filming that. I should just seal this on with caulking, but for now duct tape will do because I still don't know if this is going to work. I've had some problems with filter blow-by on my mini dust collectors, so on this one I'm just taping the filters in. I need some kind of compressible seal for the lid, and for now I'll just try corrugated cardboard.
I'm at 1.8 amperes, the motor's supposed to take 1.75, but if I restrict the airflow just a bit, then I'm below the maximum power.
The cheap dryer hose is shrinking down while I'm planing a board, so at least while it's planing, my dust collector is able to take up all the air that's coming out of the planer. The planer is not leaving a whole lot of chips on the table, so it looks like dust collection is adequate. And let's see how it looks inside. Not too bad. So it's been over 2 weeks since I built this, and initially when I measured the particle counts in the air, they'd always go way up when I used it. That's because these furnace filters really aren't designed for dust collectors, and until they have a fine layer of dust on everything, they tend to pass some of the fine dust through. And looking inside here, you can see there's quite a bit of fine dust caked on everything. And if you want to build a dust collector like that, use one with coarse pleats. Not fine pleats like this one, because these would just get plugged up. And with it running, even with nothing hooked up here, the current consumption is now 1.73 amperes, so that's under its rating. And that tells me that the airflow has gone down a bit because of the dust caked on the filters. But it keeps up just fine with my jointer, and it still works okay with my planer. So overall, I call this a success, although if I was building it again, I think I'd want to use a slightly bigger motor.